Hello everyone, hope you are all having an amazing day. Today I'm going to show you how to make these cute baby booties with a huge bow. I just love how they came out. I think they can be a great spring shoes for little girls. This tutorial is for the basic 0 to 6 months size. It's available as written pattern here on my blog and with one additional size in my Etsy shop as an inexpensive, beautifully designed and ad-free PDF file. We will start this tutorial with how to make an upper part of the shoe. So if you are not coming from the sole video, please check on that video before you begin crocheting this upper part. All the links are in the description box below. Without further ado, let me show you what you will need for this tutorial. First off, you will need some yarn. I'm using DK weight 50% cotton and 50% polyester yarn in gray and light purple color. You can choose any color or brand you prefer. Two crochet hooks, 3.5mm or E4 crochet hook and 4mm or G6 crochet hook. Some thread and a sewing needle. Stitch markers. Two press studs. Yarn needle. And a pair of scissors. Let's start with the tutorial. I'm starting with a sole that is already made. You will need two crochet soles. They have to have 44 stitches in their last round. The best way to make them is to follow my crochet tutorial for crochet baby sole. You can find the link in the description box below. Before you start crocheting the upper part, turn the nicer side of the sole towards you and make sure the nicer side will be on the outer side of the shoe. Find the middle of the heel. Now join the yarn with the sole with chain 1. Use your 3.5mm crochet hook and start crocheting your first round. Start in the same stitch. Work one single crochet into every stitch all the way around. Make sure you're working into back loops only. If you want, you can work your first few stitches around the yarn tail and hide it between the stitches, or you can take a yarn needle and weave them in later. Work into back loops only. At the end of this round, you should have 44 stitches in total. Do not forget, slip stitch does not count as a stitch, so make sure you skip it and really end the round with only 44 stitches and not 45. We are in our second round. Chain 1. Work 1 half double crochet into next 44 stitches. Start the round in the same, so in the base of the chain or also in the first stitch of the round. Join the round with a slip stitch. At the end of this round, you should have 44 stitches in total. Round 3. Chain 1. Work 1 single crochet into next 11 stitches. Join first two stitches with a half double crochet to together stitch and work one half double crochet stitch into next two stitches. Repeat this sequence 5 times. Join the next two stitches with a half double crochet to together stitch. Now work one single crochet into next 11 stitches. Join the round with a slip stitch. At the end of this round, you should have 38 stitches in total. Because the seam that should be in the middle of the heel is a little bit off, we will start our next round not in the very first, but in the second stitch of the round, and we will move the round for one stitch on our right. That way we will end our round in the slip stitch that we usually do not count as a stitch. Round 4, chain 1. Work one single crochet into next 12 stitches. work one half double crochet into next one, join next two stitches with a half double crochet two together stitch, now repeat double crochet two together stitch four times. Join next two stitches with a half double crochet two together stitch. Work one half double crochet stitch into next one. Work one single crochet into next 12 stitches. Work your last stitch of this round into the slip stitch from the previous round. Now join the round with a slip stitch. At the end of this round, you should have 32 stitches in total. As you can see here, your starting stitch is in the middle of the heel again. Round 5. Chain 1. We will start this round in the very first stitch, or also call it in the base of the chain, like we did in our first few rounds. Work one single crochet stitch into next 11 stitches. Join next two stitches together with a half double crochet two together stitch. Repeat double crochet to together stitch 3 times. Now join the next two with a half double crochet to together stitch. And work one single crochet into next 11 stitches. Join the round with a slip stitch. At the end of this round, you should have 27 stitches. Now cut the yarn and fasten off. Now we are going to be making the middle part of the shoe. This will be just one row of half double crochet stitches that will connect the upper part with the strap. Find 8 stitches on the middle of the heel, make sure you skip a slip stitch and join the yarn with a chain 1. Start in the same stitch and work one half double crochet into each stitch, then cut the yarn and fasten off. straps. Pattern for the strap for the left and right shoe is exactly the same. The only difference is in how you attach the strap on the middle part, but we will work on that part later. We will start with a foundation chain and chain 35. Start in the second stitch from the hook and work one half double crochet into next 34 stitches. Now repeat this row 2 more times. Meet me back when you finish all 3 rows of half double crochet stitches. Bow. Take some purple yarn and create a slip knot. Use your 4mm crochet hook and chain 11. Start in the second chain from the hook and work one half double crochet stitch into next 10 stitches. Pause the video here and meet me back when you finish. Wrap the yarn around the middle of the bow and attach the bow on one side of the strap. Make sure that all the parts are carefully attached. Assembling. Now we will assemble all the parts together. We will start off by attaching the press studs on the strap. Attach one part of press stud on the opposite side of the bow and attach the other one on the same side but on the other end of the strap. Attach the strap on the shoe on the 8 half double crochet stitches that we call middle part. But be careful, if you're working on the right shoe, the bow should be on your right, when you are facing the heel and the strap should open away from you. And if you're working on the left shoe, turn the strap so you will have the bow on your left, and when you will open the shoe, the strap will open away from you. Attach the strap on the middle part, but skip first 4 stitches on the part of the strap that has just a press stud. The part with the bow will go around the ankle and will be attached on the press stud from the other side. Take the sewing needle and join 8 stitches from the middle part with 8 stitches on the strap. As you can see here, I am sewing around the yarn tail and I will hide it between the stitches right away. And that's it! Cute crochet baby shoes for little girls, perfect for springtime. Let me know what you would like to see next in the comments below. That would be all for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've learned something new. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. It helps me to share it with more crocheters around the world. Subscribe if you haven't already. I release new videos almost every week. Tag me on social media using hashtag CrobyPatterns if you decide to make this crochet baby shoes. I always love to see what's on your hook. Thank you so much for stopping by, and until next time, bye!